And I saw Jesus again. He was just standing there. And I was like, oh, I was like, oh my God, it's Jesus, look, look, look. And she was like, oh, I can't. She was just stunned. She was just stunned. And I was like, oh my gosh, he's here, he's here, he's here. And this one was actually different. God was picking up everybody. A lot of people, I guess it's the same thing. The dead were coming, the dead were going up first. And when God was picking the regular people, like the people that were still alive, when he was getting them, I noticed he was being very picky of the people he brought up there with him. Like, I'm not kidding on this one. He was very, very picky. He was looking for like a flawless bride. And I went up to him and I mean, God looked at me and he was like, I was terrified. I was like so scared, like he was not gonna take me. I was like, Lord, please take me with you. And he looked at me and he said, you're coming with me. And but at first it looked like he was not gonna take me. I promise you, it looked like he was hesitating to take me. And I was like, God, come on, you know me. And then he grabbed me. And then he was like, of course you're coming. And then he took me. He said, of course you're coming. Then he took me. And there was another woman behind me. I don't know. It's like after he took me, I've already went up in the sky. It's like I was there still, but looking into other people and what they had to go through for God to take them. This one woman, she was wearing okay, she was a little extremely over, like her outfit was completely, let's just say she was very, very sexy looking. She was a hot woman. I mean, she was very beautiful and she had a lot of skin showing in her whole entire body, like completely sealed off. Like her stomach was showing, she had piercing, she was just, but she was a Christian. She gave her life to God and everything, but she was also dressing not very modest. God said, I'm looking for a modest bride also. I was like, what? And it hit me like, wow, I used to dress like that. I mean, for a long time, that's all I wore. And I had no idea that that mattered. And in that dream, it did. Like, it mattered. He actually looked at what we're wearing. I used to fight people on this. I used to complain, whine, moan, whatever. And jobs I used to do, I used to be like a model and stuff like that. And I would wear a bunch of sexy clothes and stuff like that. And I was like, wow. So let's just say I had to repent when I woke up from this dream. And he didn't take her, even though she loved God and her heart was with him. It's just certain things she didn't do according to God's law, and he didn't take her. He said, "Now you have to stay here and feel the wrath upon this world." And it was like, it was a lot of other people were getting left behind, like sins we do when we don't repent from, will keep us from going up in the clouds with God. I mean, getting raptured. I'm sorry. It was just showing me that bunch of sins that we will commit will keep us here if we don't repent and turn away from those sins. So I actually went into my closet. I am doing a big donation, and I mean, I'm completely going to change my clothes after that. I'm not wearing just anything anymore. I know sometimes you want to look nice for your loved one, whatever, but I have a different thinking right now. And nothing is worth me being left behind over. Nothing. I was taken. I mean, God, I guess there was nothing wrong. I mean, she was really, really like, let's just say I would never wear what she would wear. Like it was a little extreme. But I'm not gonna get it wrong. I mean, don't get me wrong. I used to dress like that back then when I would go out clubbing and stuff like that. Back then, back then. But I was like, okay, wow. So she got punished over that. And I was like, wow, that was something I needed to add because it was clear in my dream she got left behind because of that. And she didn't repent because she was still dressed like that. And it was bad. It wasn't like you had to dress like an old lady or anything, because I was just wearing like regular clothes, you know. I didn't have nothing, you know, too dramatic. You know, I had a tight shirt on when I was there, and I didn't get left behind over it. But what she was wearing, I guess it basically was just trying to say, don't go too extreme, you know, too extreme showing your body off and all that stuff. But I'm not trying to throw any judgment or anything like that. Don't get me wrong. I used to do the same thing. I used to dress all type of ways, extremely sexy, extremely, extremely sexy. But I stopped. Since I've started doing all this, you know, talking to God and building a strong relationship with Him, my life completely changed. My outlook, my clothing, everything. I had to change everything. So I had to change all that. I'm not talking about that. It was just something I saw in my dream. A person got left behind over what she was wearing. And I was like, wow. I couldn't believe that. It's like God wanted me to see that. So, like I said, I'm getting rid of a lot of clothes out of my closet. A lot of clothes are gonna get either donated or thrown out. But after he was done rapturing all the people, he went back up in the clouds again, and we went to heaven. And I woke up. I woke up. It was just the second dream. I mean, the second dream into the dream. It got me a little rattled, 'cause that when I saw that lady got left behind over what she was wearing, it really bothered me a lot. 'Cause I used to dress like that. I used to dress very, very sexy. I mean, those were the clothes I used to wear all the time. If it wasn't showing much, it was not mine. But thank God I turned away from that. I started thinking, and I didn't want to continue to dress like that anymore. And yeah, I had to change all that. So that was something I needed to repent from.